Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you are a regular viewer of my channel, you know that I am shooting someplace else. That's just because we are having some renovations in the building where the studio is, so I have to shoot here, home at the office. In today's video, I'll show you, if you are a beginner in using Fusion, how to do a super simple slide in text effect just like this. And that is a pretty easy effect to pull off. If you are new to this channel and like this kind of content, you can of course always subscribe to the channel because it's going to help the channel out a bunch. Also, if you really want to give me like a cup of coffee, you can use the thanks down below the video and push that. That would help out the channel tremendously. Well, with that out of the way, let's get right into this video. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and first thing we need to do is to take a Fusion composition, and you can find that under effects, and it's right here in the top, and you're just going to drag that down to the timeline. I already did that, so I'm just going to highlight that and I'll go straight into Fusion. This is the setup. I have a background connected to the media out, and then I have a text added into a merge, so it's merged over the background. And the text here is just a small little text, fast effect. And I'm going to show you how to do a slide in effect. So maybe you want to change the color of one of the words. For instance, if I want my effect word to be a different color, how do you actually do that? Because if you just go to the color here and you're going to change that, for instance, to red, you know, you're changing everything, and that's not what you want. So how do you actually do that? Okay, you do that by right-clicking up here and then go into character level style. And what that is doing is it'll give you access to the modifiers right up here. And we're going to click the modifiers tab. And for instance, if we just highlight the word effect here, we can actually change the color to, let's say, this orange light color. And maybe we also want the size to be a little bit bigger. So you can see that it's actually affecting the title itself. So let's say we want that to be a little bit bigger, something like that. That's looking pretty good. So I'll go back to tools, and in fact, I want to go into my layout here and I want to do my animation now. And it's super simple. So let's say I want to do my animation at frame 24. I want to be at this particular place in the composition. And I'll do that simply by going up here on the layout and in center, and I'm just going to click a keyframe right here. Then I'll just go pretty fast back to zero. And either I can move the center this way, or I can simply just drag this right out of frame like that. So this is what we have, a super simple little effect, but of course we can make this a little more fluent and a little better if we go up and use our spline editor, which is right up here in the top. If nothing is selected here, just select the top one and you're going to select everything right here. And we take a look right here. We have our two keyframes right here. This is our movement. And you know what, if we highlight this and right click, we can add in an ease in animation. So we go into ease, and there are different ones you can choose for. For this example, I'm just going to use out back cubic. And now we have this little animation here. So it's very cartoony and maybe a little too much, but we can actually change that pretty easy by taking this handle here and dragging that down. So we're going to make the effect where it bounces around a little bit faster, something like that. Would look kind of fun. Cool. You know, I might want to add in a some kind of rotation again. So if I go to my frame here, 24, and I go into the rotation, and in the C, I just set in a keyframe, and then I'll go back some frames. So around just before it spikes here or turns out. And I can push this either to go like up, but I want it to be like it's breaking down or something, like a brake on a car or something like that. So maybe we'll go like -10.4 or something like that. And then I'll just go to the beginning and I'm simply just going to push this back to 0, like so. And then we have this little animation here. I think that looks kind of cool. Put in some cool sound effects and that would be pretty fun. Also, there is, of course, a couple of things we can do again to make this a little bit better. We can, of course, take all of our keyframes we have right here and highlight all of our keyframes. And if you push F on your keyboard, it's going to flatten out all of your animations, all of the keyframes, and it's going to look way more smooth. Something like that. Last thing to do, I'm just going to close down the spline. It's actually to add in motion blur, and you can do that in the text itself if you just go to settings and just push motion blur. And when you've done that and added some sound effects, this is what you have. Okay, so that is how you do a super quick slide-in text effect. Of course, you can do this different way by sliding it from the top, or you can zoom in, but the way you do it is the exact same. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.